So it is Friday and we are back with our championship score predictions. Coming up in today's video, we got a lot to talk through. Obviously, we had all the midweek action going on in the championship, which will be discussed throughout today's video. So feel free to get your comments in as to what you thought of all the midweek games. And as well as that, all this weekend's games will be in the description down below so that you guys can go ahead and make your score predictions. Before we do hop into anything though, let's give a shout out to our sponsors over at One Football. As always, their link will be in the top line of the description down below. If you are looking to keep up to date with all the action that is going on this weekend, then One Football is the best place to go ahead and do that. You can get live updates to your phone when all the goals do go in. You know, myself as a Preston fan, I'm always looking to keep up to date with all the sides around us when I'm going on the North End game, so it's always a handy one to have, getting live updates to your phone as to when the goals do go in. So like I said, One Football, link down below. And before we do hop into my predictions, I will include your guys' score predictions on screen now. So if any of you did get your midweek score predictions correct, then fair play to you guys. We had some big results going on. All of the bottom three winning this weekend. It's getting closer at the bottom. And the picture for promotion is also an interesting one. So we'll discuss those results throughout, but without any further ado, let's hop into these score predictions. So starting things out with the early kickoff, which sees Hull going up against Leeds. Now Hull find themselves on an absolutely shambolic run at the moment. They're without winning the league in their last 9 matches, 7 of those games being defeats. They only find themselves 4 points off the relegation zone, and with all the bottom three winning this weekend, I think a lot of Hull fans are nervously looking over their shoulders. Added to that as well, Tom Eaves is going to be out for the season, which means they're relying on goals from someone like Josh McGuinness, who's got 3 for the season so far. It's not a good situation. It was another loss for them in midweek against Barnsley. Barnsley more than deserving of all 3 points, really. They had numerous chances. In the end, Coley Woodrow's goal was enough to win it. But they're going up against this Leeds side, and I don't think a lot of people will be giving Hull much hope going into this one. Leeds have bounced back in the Championship recently, winning their last 3 matches. What's been most important for Leeds lately has been to sort out their defensive record. You know, when they went on that bit of a dodgy run, they were conceding silly goals. I think that everyone accepts now that Leeds are going to create a lot of chances, but aren't going to be that clinical. You know, we've seen that throughout the season so far. But if they can sort out their defence, then they will be riding high and going for promotion this season. And that has been the case lately. 3 clean sheets in their last 3 matches, and they're now bang back on form. Good goal from Click in midweek to beat Borough in the end, but the one goal was enough. In this one, I fancy Leeds to dominate, although I don't think they'll absolutely batter Hull with the score. And I think they will with chances, but like they usually are, they'll probably miss a few here and there. For a score prediction though, I'm going to go for a 2-0 away victory. I think Leeds should breeze through this one, really. Next up, we then got Blackburn going up against Swansea. 2 sides who are going for the playoffs, but couldn't really capitalise in midweek on the losses for Bristol City and Preston, as Blackburn drew 0-0 with Stoke. And then we saw Swansea losing against Fulham at Craven Cottage in the last minute, thanks to a Mitrovic goal. In that game, Swansea had, I thought they got desperately unlucky, to be honest. I thought they had a couple of really strong penalty appeals turned down in that one. Obviously, Fulham had a penalty for themselves. That was saved well by Woodman, but in the end, Mitrovic was on hand for the late winner. So, in that aspect, Swansea did get quite unlucky. They're looking to bounce back in this one. Blackburn in their game against Stoke. It was a game where the endeavour was there from Blackburn. They just couldn't quite find that quality in the final third. It was one of those games where if they had nicked it from a set piece or something like that, not too many eyebrows would have been raised, really. But perhaps Mowbray like left the subs a little bit too late to really make an impact on the game. But overall, Stoke came with a game plan to Ewood Park to sit fairly deep, and they defended well and ended up coming away with a draw. So getting into this one, perhaps Swansea's game plan would play into Blackburn a little bit more for this one. They'll be looking to play a bit more of a higher line, looking to put their game plan on Blackburn, looking to create those spaces going forward from wide areas and open up. That will give someone like Adam Armstrong a bit more of a license to then get in behind. But to be honest, I don't think that there'll be all too much in it between these two. I'm going to go for a 1-1 draw. Thief is back in Swansea. If either side is able to claim all 3 points, it'll be a big statement for their top 6 push. Next up, we then got Cardiff going up against Brentford. 2 sides who had disappointing midweeks. Cardiff losing at home against Nottingham Forest, where it wasn't necessarily a bad performance. They just lacked a real spark inside the final third, really. You know, with the absence of Lee Tomlin, with the injury that he's recently picked up, I think could be out for up to 8 weeks. And that's going to be a massive blow for Cardiff for the rest of the season, and could put an end to their playoff hopes, which are sort of dwindling around at the moment. They are 6 points off the top 6 at the moment, and with back-to-back losses now, you know, those 2 games without Tomlin, they failed to score. I'm not sure how much more they're able to be able to push up without that creativity. Going up against this Brentford side though, who they themselves fell to a disappointing loss in midweek, losing against Luton. They themselves are missing a big player at the moment in the form of Pontus Janssen. You know, it was only a few weeks ago that we were talking about how good Brentford were defensively, but without Janssen, Luton, I mean, they've not kept a clean sheet in their last seven matches now, and that 2-1 defeat away against Luton in midweek really highlighted some of their inefficiencies at the back. You know, both Luton goals came from crosses that Brentford failed to defend coming in. So, and with Cardiff liking to play in that way, you know, they are quite a robust side, especially at home. They've only lost two games so far this season at home, one of them being in midweek against Forest. Cardiff, with the way that they like to be with set pieces, Will Vokes with those long throws, they can cause Brentford some problems in this one. For a score prediction, I'm going to go for a 1-1 draw in this one. I think that Brentford may get through it with a point, but I'm not sure I can see them taking all 3 points. FIFA's going to say it will be 1-0 Brentford. And then next up, we got Fulham going up against Preston. Fulham did bounce back in midweek, beating Swansea. Mitrovic securing that one, screening in the 94th minute after he had missed a penalty a few minutes before. So quite a dramatic one in that game. Going up against this Preston side, who, I mean, we've lost two of our last three matches, but we still find ourselves in the top six, mostly because a lot of the sides below us aren't very consistent at the moment. A lot of teams are tailing off towards the end of the season. Bristol City, who are only 3 points below us in seventh, have only won one of their last five matches now. I'm no doubt that everyone's form is eventually going to pick back up, so this is a good opportunity for Preston to be targeting some points, really. We did win this fixture earlier on this season at Deepdale, but going away to Craven Cottage isn't going to be an easy one. Preston did lose in midweek 2-0 against West Brom. To be honest, it wasn't a very good performance, but it was against the best team in the league away from home. West Brom scored in good moments, 6 minutes in and then just before half-time. The red card to Daniel Fisher for a tackle on Callum Robinson in the second half didn't help things. However, that red card has since been rescinded, so Daniel Fisher will be available for this weekend, which is absolutely massive news. You know, having Fisher available, I couldn't imagine Tom Clark in 1v1 situations against the likes of Knockout and Cavallero. I love Tom Clark, but his mobility down that side, he'd get absolutely torn apart. So this one, for a score prediction for Preston, it's very much dependent on what side Alex Neil goes for. I was quite surprised with a couple of the team selections he went for at West Brom. You know, to be starting Nugent after how well Stockley did against Hull, I thought was a bit of a strange one. Overall, I'm not all too confident coming into this one. I think that Fulham may look to put a bit of a run together after that Swansea game. They've still got some tough games coming up after this one as well, but I think that they'll look to capitalise on their home form, and they may just edge through this one. I'm going to go 2-1 Fulham and hope I'm proved wrong, with Thief saying it'll be 2-0 Fulham. And next up, we then got Huddersfield going up against Charlton. Two sides, both on 39 points. Both sides 2 points outside the relegation zone. Now, the relegation battle in the Championship this season is absolutely fascinating, for the reason that anyone up to about 16th in the table could still feasibly be relegated. That goes up to Reading, and below that, it's anyone's game at the moment. And with the top three picking up in form lately, we don't normally see this. Normally, at least one side sort of dead and buried by this point, and then maybe one or maybe two more sides will still be picking up the odd result here and there. But all three of the bottom three have been picking up in form, and that has led to the likes of Huddersfield and Charlton being dragged straight back down into this. Now, Huddersfield did pick up a big result in midweek. They beat Bristol City against the Cardiff, really. Now, I'm not sure how many people were backing them for that one, but I feel like with Huddersfield, the additions that they made in January have certainly made a positive impact on them. You know, the opening goal, the Chris Willett goal in that game against Bristol City was a fantastic finish, and then the penalty from Colin Grant was enough to wrap up all 3 points. Charlton, on the other hand, devastating loss to Sheffield Wednesday, conceding in the 95th minute to go ahead and lose that one. I feel like their bad luck may continue in this one, with Huddersfield having a bit more going forward at the moment, and with them being at home as well. I'm just edging towards a 2-1 home victory. Thieves are going to go 1-0 Charlton. Massive game, that one. And then to another massive game at the bottom of the Championship. That is Luton going up against Stoke. Now, God knows what the Championship table's going to look like at the end of this weekend. If Luton win this one, they'll only be 2 points behind Stoke, and everything will just be flipped on its head. Luton lately have found themselves in a terrific vein of form. They've won three of their last four matches, and I mean, a few weeks ago I thought they were dead and buried. I didn't think that they had maybe the quality in there to survive, but also that sort of grit about them. But they showed that in the Brentford game. They were absolutely fantastic, had numerous chances in that one, defended really well for it as well, which has been a criticism that has been thrown at Luton quite justly so far this season, but lately they've really tightened up that area. Going up against this Stoke side, who I thought picked up a good result in midweek, a goalless draw against Blackburn, who have been in good form lately. You know, to go away from home there, defend as well as they did, not a bad point on the road at all. And with their home form on the whole being decent, Stoke, over their last sort of 10 games there, you know, they beat Cardiff 2-0 at the weekend. What they'll look to do is grind out these away performances and then pick up all 3 points in those remaining home games that they got left. But with Luton, there seems to be something about them at the moment. The only annoying thing for Luton is there's two sides above them. Wigan and Barnsley are also winning matches at the moment, but I think the Championship table is going to continue and get even even tighter at the end of the weekend, and I'm just edging towards a 1-0 loss in this game. FIFA says it's 0-0. I think that one could be a very nervy one. Next, we then got Millwall going up against Bristol City. Millwall find themselves 6 points off the top six at the moment, whereas Bristol City find themselves three. The form of each of them, though, has been sort of tailing off lately. Both of them have only won one of their last five matches in the league. Bristol City have let a few opportunities slip by them lately, obviously. They did have those two back-to-back games against West Brom and Leeds, so I sort of let them off the hook for losing those two matches, as it could happen to anyone, you know, the two best sides in the league. In midweek, though, against Huddersfield, a lot of people thought that we may see them bouncing back in that one. It wasn't the case. Huddersfield beat them 2-1. This one against Millwall is going to be another tough test for them. No one outside the top six, or even Preston, who occupied that latest playoff spot, seems to have much consistency about them at the moment, and it is anyone's game if anyone's able to put a run together, but judging by performances and results, goals scored, goals conceded, I just don't know who's got it in the locker anymore to go ahead and finish in the top six. Millwall had that goalless draw in midweek against Birmingham. It wasn't their greatest game going on. It was a lot of the game contested in midfield with not all too many clear-cut chances. Birmingham did have quite a bizarre goal ruled out, but in the end, nothing was between the two sides. For this one as well, I don't think there's going to be all too much to split them. I'm going to go for a 1-1 draw. Thief is going to say it'll be 1-0 Bristol City. Then we got QPR going up against Birmingham. Nothing really separates these two in the league. 46 points for each of them. Birmingham in midweek, it was a weird game against Millwall. Not the best one going on this weekend, but the goal they had ruled out was just bizarre. Like, I've watched it 10 or so times, and I can't see a foul anywhere in there. So it was just a bit of a weird one that one got ruled out, really. They did have a few other chances here and there, but obviously Millwall are a tricky customer to go against. Nevertheless, it is now 9 unbeaten in the league for this Birmingham side. And up against QPR, I fancy there to be a few goals in this one. QPR did get back to winning ways in midweek themselves. They beat Derby by 2-1. Derby not being the easiest customers to come up against lately as well. Two well taken goals from QPR in that one. The assist for Eze for the second goal switched in to Che was absolutely fantastic. Great little run and then ball into him. So for this one, I don't like backing the end to QPR at Loftus Road. You've always got a couple of goals in them, but Birmingham, with the way they're playing at the moment, won't be easy either. I'm going to go for quite a lively 2-2 draw in that game. With FIFA saying it'll be 1-0 Birmingham. And then next up, we got Reading going up against Barnsley. Another big game at the bottom of the Championship. Now, if Barnsley win this one this weekend, that will seriously shake up the bottom of the Championship. They've won their last three matches. The endeavour's there from them at the moment. It was another good performance in midweek, beating Hull by 1-0. Woodrow with the only goal of the game, but they had other chances to go on and wrap that one up earlier. It's a good time to be playing this Reading side as well at the moment, with an awful display from their midweek, losing 3-0 at home to Wigan. Defensively, absolutely all over the place. I mean, the third goal that Wigan scored, what on earth were Reading doing defensively? Liam Moore looked like he was straight out of a retirement home with the pace that he was getting back at. Embarrassing from Reading. They had nothing going through midfield, and Reading are a really bizarre side to watch because they sort of ebb and flowed throughout the season of being terrific to watch and then absolutely awful. Midweek was an awful performance. Can they bounce back in this one? I'm not sure, because I think it's Barnsley that wants it more at the moment. I'm going to go 2-1 Barnsley in this game. With FIFA saying, they'll be 1-0 Barnsley. Next, we then got Sheffield Wednesday going up against Derby, and Wednesday have finally done it. They finally scored a home goal at Hillsborough in 2020. It's only taken them until almost the end of February, but to be fair to them, it was deserved 3 points in that game, and to be honest, they probably should have scored a couple more goals. If it wasn't for some fantastic saves from Dylan Phillips, the Charlton goalkeeper, Wednesday would have had that game wrapped up sooner, but a much better performance from Wednesday, much more assured in that one, and they'll be looking to take that forward now for the rest of the season. Stephen Fletcher with his first goal since returning from injury. How much of a miss has he been for Sheffield Wednesday in recent weeks? They're going up against this Derby side who were pretty poor in midweek. I think it has to be said, losing against QPR, couple of defensive lapses in concentration, and going forward, that lack of clinical ability, which we were seeing especially more of at the start of the season, was seeping back into that game at Loftus Road. And for Sheffield Wednesday, I'm actually going to fancy them. They've got a bit more of a goal scoring touch about them. They look a bit more dangerous going forward now. They should have scored more in midweek, and they scored three against Birmingham at the weekend. For this one, I'm going to back Wednesday for another win. I'm going to go 2-1, with FIFA saying it'll be 1-0. And then we've got West Brom going up against Wigan. West Brom continuing their impressive run of form in midweek, beating North End by 2-0. It was more than deserving of all 3 points, their performance. I thought they were brilliant going forward, created a lot of chances. Callum Robinson at the centre of that performance had a hand in creating both goals, and ultimately it was just a complete home performance. They were really good in that one. Played some nice football going forward, and you can see why they are in the position they are in the table at the moment. I think they've won 5 of their last 6 games now. Wigan, though, lately have had an upwards trajectory in form. Their performance in midweek was absolutely brilliant. We were touching it previously when we talked about Reading. Beat them 3-0 away from home. I mean, that opening goal from Kiefer Moore, oh my God, what a finish. Such a brilliant touch to go back in himself with the back heel and then flick it into the far post. Absolutely brilliant from Keith Moore. He seems to be banging form for Wigan at the moment. And like I said, with how close the bottom of the championship is now, it really is anyone's guess as to who is going down. You know, a month or so ago, those bottom three looked pretty much nailed on, but now it's been blown wide open. Can Wigan pull off another upset in this one, though? It may be one step too far. I think that West Brom's quality ultimately may show through. I'm going to back the Baggies for a 2-0 home victory in this one. FIFA is going to go for an upset, saying it'll be 2-0 Wigan. I'm interested to see which way you guys are swaying for that one. And this weekend in the Championship, we do have some Monday night football going on between Middlesbrough and Nottingham Forest. Now, Middlesbrough really find themselves in a bit of a perilous position at the moment. On 37 points, if they lose, they could find themselves in the bottom three this weekend, should results go against them. And this game against Nottingham Forest isn't coming at an ideal time, you know. With the way that Forest are playing at the moment, they picked up a good 3 points in midweek, picking up all 3 points away at Cardiff, which isn't an easy place to go to. Thiago Silva's goal enough for the win in that game. Well worked, and they did have other chances to go and wrap it up after that, but the one goal was enough given the fact that they did keep the clean sheet. Now, Forest's sort of Achilles heel so far this season has been against the sides in sort of the bottom region of the table. So if they get through this one, it'll be quite the statement for them going forward. I do still think that Leeds are catchable. You know, Leeds could still have a wobble in there for the remainder of the season. There's 6 points separating Forest and them at the moment. So should Leeds slip up, Forest are going to want to be in the position where they can capitalise on it. And it's games like this which are going to make the difference for them. And I think that they will get through this one. With the way that Borough are playing at the moment, with not a lot of confidence, not much going forward either, I'm going to back Forest for all 3 points in this one. I'm going to say it'll be 1-0. I think the one goal may be enough to do it once again, with Thief saying it'll be 2-0 Forest. But guys, they have it there on my Championship score predictions for what I fancy to happen in this weekend's game. So as always, do get your thoughts in the comments down below as to what you see happening for this weekend. But apart from that, that will now wrap it up for today's video. So if you're going to enjoy, make sure to leave a like. It is always massively appreciated. Make sure you subscribe for a bit of regular Championship content. But apart from that, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.